According to the 2021 annual Crime and Traffic Road Safety Report, 1,390 border border riders and 512 passengers died in road crashes. Parliament says there's need to regulate the conduct of the border border industry in the country. Border border riders we spoke to say they only get a bad rep when it comes to accidents because of a few bad apples among them.
People who drive themselves, they don't also know how to drive well, or to use road signs, or to use the roads very well. Parking is not good.
They say while most of them joined the industry after undergoing proper training on road safety measures, their business has been infiltrated by unprofessional people who take advantage of the loopholes in regulation.
On my side, I'm saying that we are not the ones for the borders, because every border who drives a motorcycle, they call him a border border. Yet it's not a border border. We border borders, we know how to drive, to use the way very well. But the problem is the people who get money and buy their motorcycles and they start driving themselves when they don't know how to use the roads.
Abantu bangi barura umuntu n'abakaro umuntu n'avuga pikipiki bamanya manyo gwa boda.
We are usually accused of being careless at riding border borders, but people need to know that not everybody they see on bikes is worth being called a person in the transport industry. For us who are in the border border business, we know all traffic rules and we adhere to them well. We are only let down by people who sell their maize, buy a motorcycle and start ferrying people. These are the ones responsible for most accidents. The border border cyclists say law enforcers should also put pressure on other road users such as taxis and stationary vehicles that park on the side of the road that have seen people like the late Aponye die.
Even then, if you see our rolling drivers, they just come and park anyhow. They don't follow the road signs. It comes when they are easy and the taxi goes.
We get a lot of negative feedback, even from the president, which is unfortunate. There is need to weed out the bad apples. We request that the government puts up measures to safeguard our business. Please note that even other road users can cause accidents. It's not just us. They have also asked the government to reduce the cost of riding permits so that anyone in the border border business can be able to afford it. They say this will help them streamline their business.
The government should reduce on the money of the permit. The money which we pay on the permit so that everybody can afford it. So that everybody can be easy to afford it.
Amza Ategeka, the chairperson of the border border in Kagadi district, has asked the government to regulate the driving schools in Uganda because some of them are not doing what they are supposed to do.
Okurora oli na imuka na alime bichori na alime mucheri na alime bihimba na gudahara na afuna emilioni itane kichweka na agena na agura pikipiki.
Rebecca Nantumia, the field manager of Wendy Driving School, says border border riders are stubborn and not willing to adhere to traffic rules despite the efforts they put in training them. Nantumia has asked the government to tighten the traffic rules and ensure that every road user has adhered to traffic rules.
Some traffic police on the road, they allow people to move on without permits, to move on when they have made mistakes on the road. That's not right.
Report by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.